Audience, we can take questions now. Whom do you want to ask?
Yeah, it is especially to sir.
Dr. Sumit Chaudhary?
Yeah.
Oh, there is one question for Dr. Sumit Chaudhary.
Yeah, there was a patient I operated 3 months back. It was a case of uveitis. Post-operatively, the patient is fine, but the chamber is very shallow.
You can sit and answer.
Sumit, the pressure is around 10, what we achieve. There is a myopic shift. The chamber is very shallow.
Sumit,
so should we...
You can sit and talk.
So should we do something or leave the patient just like that? The pressures are controlled, there is a myopic shift, but the chamber is very shallow.
Was there a time period?
Three months now.
3 months, sir, you have to intervene.
Okay.
Because the short period you may not intervene, you have to look for the normal set.
Yeah.
Wait and watch, but now you have to intervene. You may...
The patient is fine, the vision is 6x6, the pressure is well controlled.
The chamber is very shallow.
But the chamber is very shallow. Should we intervene or not?
Is it touching the cornea?
No, it's not touching the cornea, but in the periphery, it's almost touching the limbus.
Myopic shift.
So, what is the choroidals? Are choroidals there?
No, there are no choroidals now.
There are no choroidals, and you are not finding any improvement or deterioration within the 3 months period.
No.
Was it? It is kind of a late hypotony when there are no.
No, the hypotony was never there. It was maybe in the initial three or four days the hypotony might have been there, but now it is stable. But the only thing is the chamber is very shallow and there is a myopic shift.
Yeah, was it an angle closure patient?
No.
It's not an angle
uveitis
closure
patient.
So probably post uveitis it is
it was a uveitis.
It is a period of ciliary shock maybe.
It's 3 months already.
Yeah, 3 months you can.
No, from the very beginning it was shallow or
yes,
just?
Yes, from the very beginning it was shallow.
From the beginning, that's
the first post-operative, it was very shallow.
That's better to leave it.
What is the cataract status?
No, IUL is there. We did a combined surgery.
It's an IUL?
Yeah.
If the patient can
sift, answer?
I think I see. Is a 6x6 vision with?
Yeah, with minus 3 myopia.
What is your gonioscopy?
Gonioscopy is very shallow. It's very shallow.
No, but can you see?
No, angle?
You cannot see any structure.
Can you observe any
posterior synechia? No, the chamber is very shallow. No synechia is being.
Gonioscopy, is there any synechia there?
No, the chamber is so shallow.
We can't see.
We cannot see any synechia.
The total path. Yeah, Manish, want to say something?
Sir, yeah, one comment, sir. We had one patient like this which almost had 3-4 months shallow AC.
So now, when did the shallowness started?
It started around 15-20 days after surgery.
Okay, and it stayed
shallow.
For
there was
four
no
months.
Obvious choroidals also. But on UBM, we found there was supraciliary effusion. And the patient resolved with a 2-month course of oral steroids.
Exactly. So I wanted to tell you that possible. you can give a charge
we
of steroids.
Initially, a lot of steroids. But now we have stopped the steroids. The chamber, the only problem with the patient, with us is, the patient doesn't have any problem except myopia. What I am feeling is that the chamber is so shallow that tomorrow it may not increase. That is the only fear.
That you can always follow up.
So we should just wait and watch, or should we deepen the anterior chamber?
You should do an UBM and probably give a second course of oral steroid for a period of time, at least for a month, to see whether it is improving, because this is a case of prolonged ciliary shock after uveitis.
I don't think even if you give steroids, the chamber is going to deepen.
No, the chamber is not going to improve.
Yeah.
And I think you just wait and observe.
Right? Okay.
And basically, if it was an angle closure, such chambers are there after you operate on angle closures. So
that's normal.
I think you should just wait and observe.
And
do nothing. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Just a counter question.
Yes.
What if he went back and formed the AC?
What is?
If we formed the anterior chamber with a viscoelastic, this is just a query.
It might raise the pressure.
Pressure may rise.
No, may.
May.
May, but why?
Why do you want to intervene if the
pressures
are normal? That is the question.
No, because if we cannot see the angle, then maybe we may end up with PAS subsequently with the zipping up of the angle.
PAS is there.
Have you ruled out pupillary block?
There's no pupillary block.
I think we have Professor Jesse Das
in the audience.
Sir, please help us because we are not able to come to a consensus.
Thank you very much. My approach will be a little different, conservative of course. What I'll do is the first step is I'll give a bottle of mannitol to him and dilate the pupil with atropine and let him remain supine for some time, and maybe for half an hour, 1 hour, and see what is happening to the depth of the anterior chamber. Second approach, suppose it doesn't form, I won't hesitate to do a PI, put the pyrocarpine in 2-3 days, 4 days time, and then do a PI and wets. Wait for 3-4 days, 5 days, it doesn't, do a hyoidotomy, anterior hyoidotomy with the laser. And that conservative treatment might work. And you see, you just dilate it for some time, maybe for with the atropine, stronger ones, and see what is happening. In most of the cases, it does work. And if he's on Dymox or on Dordoxtops in the other eye, is he on Dymox?
That also can. No.
He's not on Dymox or any Dordoxtops in the other eye. Then I think try this for a week or so, should work.
Sir, you feel that this is basically something that is
malignancy.
A pre-malignant glaucoma sort of a thing.
That is some amount of fluid accumulation behind the lens.
Okay.
That is what is causing it.
Okay. So if you do an UBM, then
UBM will give us additional information. UBM will be whether there is accumulation or whether there is supraciliary accumulation of the fluid. But if it is just accumulation of little aqueous behind the lens, this should work.
Sir, if it doesn't work, can we go for the anterior chamber reformation with any visit?
Doesn't work. Just anterior chamber reformation doesn't work. Even if you do it a Helan, just 2 days, 3 days,
it will flag. Then it goes back.
And mind it, his vision is okay, and there is no other thing. So our intervention should be more of conservative management.
I would also like to do
The PI is already there, it's a large PI, and the pupil is already mid dilated. So do we need to do the maneuver which you are telling?
I think in spite of this thing, you give a bottle of mantle and atropinize it and watch for 2-3 days.
Sir is thinking that PI may be blocked with the lens, where there can be a situation where there is anterior shift. Anterior shift, and probably the pressure will rise, but it is yet to rise.
Exactly.
So we can just stop it before.
And the patient has become more myopic. That is exactly so.
Lens
has come.
Diaphragm has come forward.
So if you take the measures to decompress the fluid accumulation behind the IOL, should serve the purpose.
Okay.
And the first attempt will be to dilate it, and it might work.
Yeah, I think the take-home message here would be you need not always have a high intraocular pressure with an aqueous misdirection. You may also have to think it can happen with a low or a normal intraocular pressure as well. So what I would suggest is definitely you would have to do a UBM, follow the patient very closely. I would agree with the professor saying that we have to use atropine and steroids and closely follow the patient. And maybe you have to repeat a UBM and see. And conservative management is something which I would recommend first. And surgery is the remote thing and last option, which would be taken only if there is a high intraocular pressure and progression of the disease.
At least I think persistent inflammation also come into play when we talk about low IOP aqueous misdirection. So steroids has to be given in higher dose. Yeah, so automatically it can happen. If there is no other question, we are actually come to an end to this wonderful IC. And before we thank our presenters and AIOSC, I would like to thank the house full of people who has attended this IC on the last day of AIOSC. And thanks a lot. Thanks a lot from all of us. Thanks.
Yeah, he told me that. Now, do your patients refuse?
Yes.
You look at a high percentage and you inform all of them that this is.
He has to inform, otherwise, he will be sued.
How are you? Good to see you.
Thank you so much. Nice, very nice.
I had some problems.